Hello, hello. I've actually got this working somewhat now. I'm pulling up Twitch chat so we could speak to you guys. Make sure I am streaming to the correct channel. I'm gonna have to change the name on Twitch too. Man, I'm so prepared. Sorry for the guys in chat who I have been talking that I haven't been able to respond to yet. I am here now. I am watching. I'm changing the name of the stream once I remember how. See here. Get that open over here. We are set up to just spectate one of the quali lobbies right now. After that, we'll go into more stuff for streaming the actual top lobby, but I just picked one of the qualifying lobbies for this. We got Dodge's lobbies. We can see we got Cyrus, Squab, PJ, Legless, Neblol, Vectrix, and Cinereus here. Don't mind how big the bar is on the bottom. That was the very quick Photoshop job I did in order to cover up the bar you guys are gonna see in the race. So, where the heck is the. Let's see here. I swore I was set up as. I am a moderator on the channel. Let's try this. All right. Well, we got the stream name updated thanks to Sir Dark Sir, who was able to do it very quickly while at work. So, that's at least up to date. All right, looks like we're getting people in. Looks like we should be getting readied up here shortly. While we wait, go ahead and do a quick rundown of current point standings in EU. So let me get that pulled up here for you. Let's see here. Current standings, we have Valkyrie leading, RZM Valkyrie, followed by RZM Takashi and RZM Niceman. RZM 1-2-3 in the championship currently. So, looks like they have a pretty strong one there. Valkyrie was not able to score maximum points at round one, only scored 590. Imagine him and Takashi probably traded positions a few times there. In the team standings, Rise Motorsport is leading Zephyrus White, 1177 to 1104. And then 1 point behind Zephyrus White is Zephyrus Blue with 1103. So we got a close battle there between the two teams there. And if we look at privateers, Swordfish Motorsport Privateer, who I believe is Unku, yeah. He's the one that should be leading that. He's actually tied with Juiced Team, who is I can't see. He must have changed his team name after that. There is no more Juiced Team. But I could look at the standings to see who's tied with Unku and see it's, oh, it's RZM Juiced. He was probably put on the regular RZM team after round one. Here. Hey Maverick, how's it going? Sit here if anybody has any questions in chat, feel free to ask me while we wait. While we wait for this to get started up here, I'll answer what I can. I'm just waiting on a couple people left to ready up, it looks like. We got Vectrix and Legless. Alrighty. Looks like they were waiting on a couple people to join who have not responded, so we will be going without them, at least for qualifying. Okay, do I have any game sound? I do not. Let's see if I can fix that. Oh, does it work now? Lobby wanted close times for quality. Yeah, let's go ahead and take a look at that while we're waiting on this to load in. So we'll go ahead and pull up here. We got qualifying times for round one. We got RZM Legrecht currently on pole with a 101.899, followed by RZM Valkyrie with a 101.940. ZR Hey Cranky with a 102.060 in third. RZM Juiced with a 102.241 in fourth. RZM Nice Man in fifth with a 102.274. Wow. So many people in the 102s here. Basically a second between the top 10 people in that lobby. That's pretty nuts. Let me go ahead and see if I can share this with you here. Oh, looks like we are actually loading into the race, so we will just worry about that later. Alrighty. Time to give these a shot as we go through this for the race here. Split last week was a full second. Jesus. Yeah, things are looking pretty tight. So we'll take a look here. We might have one big lobby for the race today, which would be really exciting to watch. We'd have a lot going on there. And we're off. Alrighty, on board with Foxmate 21 as we get moving here, who looks to have maybe taken it a bit easy on the start. So we will go ahead and turn off that. And then I have my full control here that you guys cannot see. So we will go on board with Legless, who I believe is further up on the field here. We'll sort the ticker by time so we can get a good idea here of people's distances between them here. There's a bit of a lag point here when. Okay. There are two points of interest. All right. Stick with standard replay cameras here for the rest of quality. That was pretty interesting to play through, though. Looks like after lap one, Vetrix sits on the pole with SGR Squab right behind and Neb in third. So I think we will go ahead and go on board with Squab. And we'll go ahead and go to onboard shot so we can get a good idea of what it's like to race around this track in this car. Go ahead and get telemetry up for him right here. You can see these cars should just be under 130 into turn one if I remember right. So yeah, just barely getting up there. It's really fast these first two corners as you go through. You come through, and turn two is always much faster than you think it is because of how wide it is on the exit. You can run really wide and make turn three really easily. So as we see as we come in here, but you go through those two really fast corners into these two deceptively slow ones. Like, you could kind of send it into three, but then turn four is a crawl compared to what you feel like you've been doing. Coming out here through turn five and into the big sweeper of turn six. As you can see, just balancing the throttle through this corner as it's slightly off camber and downhill. But then you want to make sure you maximize the exit all the way, because this takes you flat out all the way into turn one. Coming through. Pretty tidy little lap there from SGR Squab. So we'll go ahead and go back here, and he's still second, it looks like, on the leaderboard here. So we will go ahead and go back to the replay camera. So let's go ahead and let's go back and take a look at PJ back here. Let's see what how he's going a little further down in the field. We got the Error 404 car here with the no livery, and then so he seems to be just fine. He's probably let everybody else go in front of him, so he gets a little bit clearer view in front of him for his qualifying session. That's pretty popular, is that even though we run ghosted sessions, so you're not affected by the other cars in front of you, if you were faster than them through sectors, a lot of people can still kind of drive in the taillights of the car in front of them. Let's go ahead and hop up here to... let's go on board with the Vectress. Yeah, I see we have a couple liveries here that didn't load. We got just plain yellow cars. That is fine. I know they have actual liveries on the cars. This is just Forza being Forza for this part. As you can see, this is, I believe, overcast conditions. So while rain is coming, the track is still pretty dry for this race here. These cars run grooved tires anyways, so there's no need to swap or worry about swapping onto wets from slicks or anything like that in these races, but it is something to keep in mind that throughout the night, the track will get slipperier and slipperier as we go. Alright, you see we've got a big cluster of people here who are all running about the same pace. Foxmate, Cyrus, we're on board with Vectrix. I believe that red car was Maverick, yep, and Cynerius. Coming out and down and finishing qualifying. Alrighty. There we go. We have our results here for this qualifying session. You see a best lap of a 102.448 for Neb, Squab with a 102.697, and Cynerius with a 102.7, I believe, is what I saw. So, we got our little bit of podium celebrations here they added so we could see everybody's driver suits and their cars. The qualifying sessions are scored by best lap. So as we see as we go through here, Cynerius had a 102.737, Red Maverick with a 102.840, and Vectrix with a 103.217 to round out the top five. After that was Foxmate, Cyrus, Legless, and PJ, followed up by Dodge, rounding out the field there. So, quick little qualifying session. Looks like there will be one big lobby for the race, it seems. Don't know that anybody else is going to come, but I believe with me we will have exactly 24, which would be pretty exciting to watch. So I'm gonna go ahead and take a little break here and figure that out and get back with you guys shortly. So, checked in. Looks like we will be going down to one lobby for the race. Anybody in chat who was paying attention, how was the sound for that? Was I too loud? Was the game too quiet? We do have one big lobby for the race, which means it's going to be very exciting to watch. I can turn my mic down a little bit. I seem to be clipping just slightly when I speak up. Sounds pretty spot on. Alrighty. I just kind of winged it on the audio level, so I was trying to play it safe there. We got 23 people for our race lobby here. And of those 23 people, you got to keep in mind, probably 15 of them are within a second of each other. It's going to be a wild bit of round here. So let me pop over here and I will little go over the top three in qualifying for you again. We got RZM Legrecht with a 101.899. We got RZM Valkyrie with a 101.940. Those are the only two people into the 101s in qualifying. And third, we have ZR Hey Cranky, the 102.060. Two more RZM lads round out the top five with Juiced and Nice Man. And then we have a squad of the ZR guys with Gallardo, Villa, Amarius, and Russo. Neblol rounds out your top 10 there with a 102.448. All right, I'm gonna come back here, actually pick my car. Apologize for that. Just sitting here at my pick car screen. Go ahead and pop into spectate, and I am good to go and out of the way. Oh, they added the challenge hub thing in here. Let's take a quick look at this. What do we got going on here? This is obviously something they just added this update, so I have just now looking through this. Oh, this is the tracking for how to get the new cars. Okay. And the driver suits they added as well. I will say this update was probably a bit light on content, but the Artura is directly relevant to some things we will probably eventually run here on Tora again. So I know we just had our TSCC series that had LMP3 and GT4 in it. The Artura would basically be a drop-in for GT4 in the future, were we to when we run it again. So. So we got here just ways to make some credits, and then the career things. Okay. Alrighty, looks like we are loading in for the race. This is pretty exciting here. Yeah, everybody's going to die very hard. It's gonna be great. Happy to be able to be here with you guys while that happens. I believe Cinereus had her time. Yeah, fixed. Everything else seems to be going pretty smooth. I'm going to try to use the point of interest camera for turn two. See if we can get everybody on that race start flying into there together. So, I believe since he's going to be starting third, we'll ride on board with Hey Cranky at the start just to see how it goes from maybe just a little off the front row, see what kind of chaos they can get up to there. we waiting on to ready up? Nobody. I was never able to do it either, freelancer. It was close, though. Corner is very fast when you use all of the curbing everywhere. There we go. Now we're launching in. Just loading in now. Should be ready to start here. Yep, here we go. Now, thanks to the way Forza here does their gridding, we don't have any way to set the grid manually, of course. We need to go ahead and call out the grid as we go. So this is currently just everybody getting put into formation. We will do a pace lap, come around, and then the cars will park in their grid spot for the start of the race again. So this is mostly just a formality of the outlap here, just so we can get everybody in the proper qualifying order. So as you can see, once again, we'll go ahead and go through the field here. Go ahead and go to this fun camera. Where is it? There we go. Pan across. Come here to Legrecht. So we have RZM Legrecht here on pole. And then we have RZM Valkyrie in second with the sister car here. Hey Cranky right here in third. The best of the ZR guys today. RZM Juiced continuing the Rise cars. You see we have the other sister car to those. RZM Nice Man with another very similar livery, but I believe they are slightly different teams. We have ZR Gallardo here in 6th. ZR Via here in 7th. Amaryllis here in 8th. Russo in 9th. This loading is annoying. We have Neblal in 10th. The Corner Hearts Garage car. SGR Squab in the very SGR colored car here. Cinerius here in her Jeanetta, sponsored Jeanetta, very fair. Red Maverick in the gold 22. ZR Taffy down here in 14th. Vetrix here in the DeWalt 88 in 15th. Foxmate in the Scalextric, yeah, Scalextric 27. We have Legless Man here in the Siemens 169. PJ in the Error 404, no livery car. Cyrus in 19th with Pac-Man's Namco car. Dodge with the Akina Speedstars 26. Apex Miata here in the, I believe that's VGP car. FV Pixels in the sister car to that, but color swapped. And Unku in the rear with the SFM car, who I believe is taking his spot further up the field, but had to sit at the back in order to call out the grid. So he also sponsored by IMB Racewear on there as well. So let's go back on board with Hei here. We will swap cameras back to the replay camera here as we see everybody slowly pulling into their grid spot here. Trying to get the make sure those tires are warm so that way they can have the best start they can. So once everybody gets parked up in their grid spot, what will happen is that was not the right thing. Unku will count down from 10 for his, oh, you see there's some confusion at the back of the grid on what side of the grid they're supposed to be on, but getting that sorted out. Unku will count down from 10 for the start of the race, and we will take off from there. Yeah, no race timer kind of sucks for that. All right, so we're actually on board with the juice here, so we get a better view of the grid. It should be starting here very soon. And they're off. Everybody's going off, going down through the list here. So you see pretty clean start for the RZM guys. They got four of them all right there into the top four. See, as they're all going through turn one like that. This is not the corner I thought it was. We will go back to a rail camera. Give us so many toys, but they don't tell us how to use them. Everything is pretty nuts back here. You see everybody's diving in like this. So we will go ahead and pop over to the replay camera. That's the wrong thing again. Professional streamer, by the way. So we have a squad of RZM, first to fourth, followed by a squad of Zephyrus from fifth to eighth. First car, not one of those two, is Neblol here in ninth, who we'll take a quick ride on board with. As they go through the final corner and onto the front stretch, you see these cars draft very, very well. So you might see some moves here into turn one from people as they try to take it off. You see two of the ZR cars trying to make a pass at each other. I believe that's Russo on Via. We will go ahead and pop back up here to the front and see if the RZM guys are trying to fight or if they're going to have some sort of team order. No, very clearly not, as Leclerc tries to go on the outside of Valkyrie, who very, very good defends, but he tries to go for the crossover. May also just be slowing himself down as Juiced looks to take the spot there. All in all, nothing really happens. Looks being given here and there, but nothing significant. They all just take off, and Gallardo leads the ZR pack behind them. Popping further back into the field, we do have some people swapping around here. Let's pop on board with Red Maverick, who is side by side with Taffy as they go through this here penultimate corner. Coming down to the front stretch, you see these cars race very, very close to each other. Oh, Vectrix got a little bit of lag, it looks like there, but he just tapped Taffy there in that final corner. See tons of moves being pulled out here. We got Cyrus pulling out here for a move. It looks like the door got closed on him, but now everybody's going on the inside of Taffy as they're three wide into turn two for a second there. Once again, lots of switchbacks back and forth going through here, back in the field. They're three wide into turn three again. Going through here, it looks like it's going to be Foxmate taking out the lead there of this pack. Vectrix followed by Cyrus as Taffy was now getting it under attack from the Legless Man and Apex Miata as these guys start to come back through the field. This is race one, Takashi. I will go ahead, pop back up. Do we still have the entire lead pack basically within a second of each other? Just take another quick look here. It's still RZM 1, 2, 3, 4, followed by ZR 5, 6, 7, 8. No real changes in position. We got Nice Man trying to be rear gunner here for the RZM guys as Gallardo finally is able to try to make a move on him into turn two. They go side by side down this little short chute here into turn three. Can Gallardo do it on the outside? Oh, he's still there. He's coming through. Looks like he might be able to finish it. They're still very side by side as the ZR guys look like they might be going side by side behind him now because of the bottle up, but Gallardo eventually does have to back out and cede that position back to Nice Man. Nice Man doing a very good job defending here. We see Via pass Amaryllis in the background there for second in this pack, but they're still going at it, so we'll go ahead and hop on board with Amaryllis. See if they sort themselves out, but the ZR guys are getting very fighty, even with each other. Obviously no real team orders going on here with these guys trying to go three wide down the front stretch, it looks like. But there is pretty much two clearly defined packs here. We got this front pack with the top about 12 and then top 13, and then we drop a couple seconds back for pack two here, which begins with Red Maverick. See, he's got himself a comfortable little one and a half second lead over Vectrix and Foxmate, who are still fighting with the rest of Cyrus and Legolas there, like they were last time we checked in on them. Tons of fighting in these cars. They're very slow. They're very easy to lose time in. So any little mistake, you just let that guy behind you catch right back up to you. You got to really be on your game when racing stuff like this, especially on momentum tracks. We have people going into turn one, so I'm going to try to catch that with this camera here. I did not. This is great. I wish I knew where I was. All right. Back to this. That's the wrong thing again. All right, driver list. All right, let's go ahead and pop back up here. It looks like there has been a little bit of a separation in the RZM guys as Valkyrie and Legrect are slowly pulling away from Juiced and Niceman. Niceman has been able to pull out a little bit of a gap here on Gallardo. It's finally gotten him off of his back a little bit as Gallardo appears to be leading the ZR train, followed by Via, Russo, and Amaryllis. They have also pulled away just a little bit, as we see Gallardo have a little bit of a mistake there. Shouldn't be too bad to defend into this corner, though. Neblol being the first of neither of those two teams there, running in ninth, with Cynerius running a bit wide there, and she is running in 10th. Hey, Cranky, remember who we were going to watch from the start in 11th, or in 3rd? He's fallen all the way down to 11th, so he's had a tragic bit of a start to this race. We have SGR Squab here in 12th, and Unku rounding out this first pack, as this second bit of pack here from Neb to Unku is still very, very fighty with each other, and can be very quickly again. It is kind of 2 4-car breakaways at the front between the RZM and ZR guys. So we're going to go ahead and hop back here to the Red Maverick fight back here. As we see tire smoke when we join, but Red Maverick, Foxmate here going at it with Legolas Man and Vectrix. It looks like that might have been Cyrus. No, Cyrus is still there. Maybe it was just maybe Taffy who maybe lost out a little bit on that turn one incident there with the tire smoke that we saw. PJ back right there in 12th with the Error 404 car hanging in there. We have FV Pixels, Apex Miata, and Dodge running at the field who are all hanging in there. Let's see, comp up here. Foxmate looks like he might be having a run. No, they're just really close here. So two very, very defined packs here between these cars. See, as they come down this front stretch here, get a lot of speed in the draft. We'll go on board here with the RZM guys. We'll go on board with Legrect here, and we'll pop up the telemetry this time. And you guys remember in qualifying we were seeing them just tickle 130 into turn one on a really good run. So I'll pop into the telemetry here, and you can see just how much faster the draft allows these cars to be into turn one. Go ahead and open this up here. He's a bit far back, so we will come back to Juiced, who has a good draft on him. So you're doing 130 much earlier in the straightaway, getting all the way up to 134, 135 into turn one with the draft. So the draft does make a big difference in these cars, being 4 or 5 mile an hour. And you could actually, it's the best way to try to make a move, is just to work up that draft in these cars and try to send it into the next corner. Pop that over to automatic. Go in here to the driver list again. Looks like Hey Cranky is back up to ninth. We missed that. Trying to watch that, but maybe a little bit of a mistake from Neb, as he's now fallen to 11th, as we see Cynerius go out onto the grass there, and now they are side by side coming through this penultimate corner. Very, very tidy still, very tidy. Neb looks like he has a slight bit alongside. Very tight, very fast corner. Yeah, Neb got very loose there because off that curb, so now you're going to see Squab go past him here onto the front stretch. Neb losing another position there. come ahead down, come through here. We're gonna have Foxmate. Looks like he is on, yep, on top of Vetrix here into turn one as he gets the move made as Vetrix tries the crossover here coming down into turn two. Very easy to do in these cars to overshoot the corner a little bit and get crossed over, but is he going to get crossed over right back? Oh yeah, very well done by Foxmate there to fight that off like that. Hold to get around Vetrix there to lead this second pack, I should add. Lots of good close racing throughout the field here. Just it's all interspersed. There's actually, I think, another pack yet now. No, I'm just seeing things. But yeah, we do have kind of three packs here because we have the back half of that ZR squad. They're three wide, of course. Backing out coming into turn one was Amaryllis there. So Via is the only ZR driver, Zephyrus driver, left hanging on to the back of that RZM team up there in fifth. As you see now, these ZR guys have started racing each other very hard. And as I say that, Russo goes slightly off track there in turn two, pushing. But we have Gallardo leading Amaryllis, leading Russo there now. And hey, Cranky right there as well. So we have four of the five Zephyrus drivers all right here under a blanket. Just behind them, of course, is Cinerius, Squab, Neb, and Unku running here in this pack. Action everywhere as we are three quarters of the way through this race. Pop back here onto Neb. I see somebody was saying that. Neb has had a bit of a rough time. It is holding on to 12th. Was running as high as 8th earlier, I believe. 8th or 9th. We've got tons of fighting going on back here with these guys. With Red Maverick, Vectrix, and Foxmate all go at it again. These guys have been fighting really hard all race. It's been really hard to look away and catch what's going on elsewhere. As you see, they are side by side coming down into turn one again. Vectrix fighting without a draft there on the inside. Has to send it pretty hard. Looks like Vectrix might be trying to... Or Legolas trying to make it three wide. Backs out of it into turn two. Smart man there. Vectrix does get the move completed here. Going by. Over Red Maverick, who now has to defend from Legolas and Cyrus. As they are now there. Legolas looking for any chance he can get here. Up on the curve. Oh, Cyrus with a really good run out of the corner. Gets a little loose. So tons of action going on there. Go ahead and pop back up here and check on the RZM guys. Yeah, it seems to be working pretty well. There's still that typical black screen. Like, if I was going to swap to LeGrect here, you still have the loading black screen. And you do this every time you swap a car, but... Overall, like... It's pretty nice. I think if you were running full tracks and not necessarily the club circuit, the POI cameras would be very good. As we see Juiced and Niceman seemingly going at it right in front of Via, who is still trying to break up that RZM top four. Via making a move on the inside of Niceman, finally. Has Niceman finally been defeated as the tail gunner? Is Via finally going to be able to get by one of them? Is they going to go side by side here into this final corner? Yes, this VOD should be uploaded to YouTube afterwards. Yeah, you do miss a lot of action, but it's fine. You see that ZR squad in the background coming out of the final corner. Via sending it on the inside. Might just can't complete that pass there as Niceman goes really wide on the exit. Finally, Via completes that pass into turn two. Niceman looks like he's going to be fighting back, though, on the outside of this corner. We haven't seen it work yet. Does he make it work? Is able to hang on there. Nope, Via is mostly able to, yeah, close the door there in turn five. So as you see now as they're going through, Via finally breaks apart that RZM 1-2-3-4 and gets up into fourth with a lap and a half left to go as they're coming around to the final lap here. We're going to go ahead and pop back here to check on Foxmate and Vetrix and them as these guys have been having a heck of a fight the whole race. But it looks like they might have finally calmed down a little bit here. Although we still have Maverick, Legolas, and Cyrus here all going at it for 16th. We got tons of racing there. PJ and Taffy are hanging on back here. Looks like Taffy might be trying to make a run back on PJ. Coming back up here. Just checking in on Squab and these guys. We do have Cinereus making a move here on Unku on the final lap. Looks like they're going to be three wide into turn two here with Neb seeing his opportunity and going on the inside. Contact, though, as they, you know, try to send three into one. Still three wide on the exit. Neb on the outside now. Unku on the inside with Cinereus in the middle. Still, Neb has to back out, but Cinereus is finally able to clear Unku here into turn five. I don't think this is going to be over anytime soon, as looks like Cinereus gets a really bad run and they go two wide behind him. We're going to pop up here, though. Valkyrie is going to win this race, it looks like. It looks like clearly ahead of Legrect, as those two have clearly driven off from the rest of them. Via was able to get around Niceman and Juiced by the end of the race, though. We're going to pop back here. The ZR guys are going to finish in 6th through 9th, it looks like. And come back here. Unku looks like he's going to just hold on for 11th between that three-way fight. Pop back here now to Vectrix. Looks like Vectrix is going to just sit here in 15th, right in front of Red Maverick. He does a nice 180 across the line. Pop back. Cyrus does get 18th. Taffy coming back here does finish 20th. We got another one. Apex Miata doing another 180 across the line. FV Pixels coming across in 22nd and coming home 23rd. We do have Dodge 26-109. Keep in mind, this is just race one, so with race two, we will have a full field invert. So once again, top three is going to be RZM Valkyrie, RZM Legrect, and ZR Via fighting through that RZM squad in order to get up to third. I'm going to need more drinks, Jesus Christ. Oh, can I just be a color commentator? Alrighty. Couldn't look over too often at the side over there. Tried to read chat when I could. There's a lot going on track. So once again, here is your finishing order. Of course, it's obviously unofficial as always, as you know, we never know what SIs and stuff may come out. But we have RZM Valkyrie followed by Legrect leading Zephyrus Villa here in third. Another pair of Rise Motorsport guys, and Nice Man and Juiced in 4th and 5th. Then we have the Zephyrus squad of Gallardo, Amaryllis, High Cranky, and Russo in 6th to 9th. Rounding out the top 10 is SGR Squab with Unku in 11th, Cinereus in 12th, Neb in 13th, Foxmate in 14th, Vectrix in 15th, Red Maverick in 16th, Legless in 17th, AX4X Cyrus, PJ back, and Zephyrus Taffy rounding out the top 20. And then Apex Miata, FV Pixels, and Dodge 26 rounding out the field there. Should be fine on the vocals. We can't fit anybody else in the lobby. See, is there any other questions I missed? It was scroll up here really fast. Oh, hey, Ash. See you there popping in. How's it going? Seems to be going pretty well. The cameras are pretty nice. It's really weird to use. I've been reusing them on a club circuit, so some of the POI cams and stuff like that aren't ideal for this kind of track layout as they were set up for the full circuit. But ASCC should be pretty great with the racing and with the fact that it's multi-class, so you can hop on board with the prototypes as they go through the GT field. Yeah, I tried the POI cams a few times, Ash. I missed all the reaction every time I used them. The rail cams are pretty cool. They're very weird to get used to because the way you have to use the joysticks to get through them. The HUD is very cluttered. I don't know if you can see exactly how big the scrolling I had to make it is. That is very large. in order to cover the control box that pops up there in the middle of the screen. I'm able to at least hide the buttons and stuff like that, so we don't have to worry about that. And then otherwise, everything just feels very large. I feel like if I had a scale option, I would run it at like 90% or 80%, I think. But what we have is what we have. Cephix, I see you asked a question there. It does use a lobby slot, yeah. So we're still stuck on 24-person lobbies, and I am taking up a racing slot, technically. Any feedback on it? Just so far, having the POI cameras track the person you're driving would be really nice instead of just popping over to one of them so they would automatically swap through them. You can swap cams with a button design, actually. If you press X, you could swap through the POI cams. It's not too bad for that, but it's very hard to know when you're not used to it, where to know which one you're going to next. Oh yeah, you can. Yeah, I'll show you next race. Yeah, I'll do it in the middle of the race next race. The other feedback I would be is that give us the option for a HUD scale, please. Our HUD is the HUD is so big. I'm on PC currently, Cephix. I didn't have any issues with frame drops or anything like that. I was watching it on OBS and I was watching it on my task manager to see usage. Usage seems pretty normal, maybe a little bit lighter than if I was driving myself. And then as for the drop frames, I don't have any dropped there. If you're curious about PC specs, I have an AMD Ryzen 5 5600X and a RTX 3070, 64 gigs of RAM. Those are about the only things that matter for streaming, really. The RAM is complete overkill. But I am using a controller dark. That is as small as it gets. It's even bigger if I were to use a mouse and keyboard. It's ridiculous for stuff like that. Yeah. So all right. Think I will be streaming to Ted so he can join me for commentating here now. Yeah, HUD scale is indeed the size of the Titanic. Keep in mind also for this race, as we're loading into it now, we will have a full grid invert. So once again, we'll have to sit here, wait for everybody to go through. Dodge will be on pole, actually, as he see him coming through now. And we'll go through the field the way they finished last time, but backwards. So we see Apex Miata cutting off PV there as he pulls out right in front of him. Gonna go ahead here. We're gonna change to the man who won last race, who was RZM. I think Legret got second. Dark is here now. Hello, Dark. All right, so I'm going to show this for since we're doing this now. I'm going to go to the point of interest cam for design here. As you can see, we are here at this one, and if I press X, we move to this one, which is oh, this is a really good one. Okay, this is into turn three. All right, so we got one into turn three there, and one on the exit of turn one, it looks like. Yes, yeah, the point of interest cams, yeah. So then we have the rail cameras. As you can see, it's really weird to get used to with the controllers. You can only go so high. I wish the rail camera went higher. It feels like photo mode. It's closer to photo mode controls here. All right. Quick rundown of the field once again. We have Dodge, Pixels, Miata in the top three, followed by ZR. Good. Following up by that is Legless here with the 169 car. Red Maverick, and then Vectrix. I need to switch the camera type here. There we go. Oh, that's the wrong thing again. Only 27. Yep. I'm getting dizzy watching this camera. I'm expecting chaos. Once again, once everybody gets lined up in their grid slot, Unku will, as the marshal in charge, will count down from 10, and the race will take off from then. So we are going to go ahead and get that point of interest camera ready as we wait for the cars to go off into turn one here. It's the only really time this is going to be a useful camera. Oh, I don't think they can hear you, Darkser. Let me fix that. Yeah, they cannot hear you. All right. Car is going off into turn one. See, we have everybody piling in here. X. The car is going through turn two. Okay. All right, Ted left because I didn't have a way to capture Discord audio on purpose. All right, lots of stuff going on here. We're going to go back to the replay camera. So there's absolute chaos on the replay camera. Oh my God. All right, we're going to go on. We're on board here with RZM Valkyrie as he goes through the field, but there is tons of stuff going on. We're gonna pop up here and ride on board with Via, I think. As Via is currently three wide in the penultimate corner coming through here. Actually, this will be a good chance to use these rail cameras they talk about. As you guys can see coming through here, just the absolute chaos this could happen. I believe this race is also in light rain. Look behind there, just there's so much happening. Just some touching here as RZM Niceman gets very loose trying to push Via here into the corner. You see they are 4-5 wide. Oh no, Foxmate goes off the track. Oh, Foxmate falls all the way back. But you see there's tons of pushing and shoving and everything going on here. Tons of stuff happening. Still 3-4 wide it looks like sometimes coming into turn 3 here. I know it's Vectrus is the one in front here, but we are on board with ZR Via here still. Tons of fighting, tons of three wide action all the way through the field. We go back to the replay cameras here. And let's get on board here with somebody a little further up. So let's see how the leader's doing, because we have Taffy on Apex Miata for the lead pretty much. Apex Miata gets very loose in that corner there off the curve as Taffy looks like Taffy goes to the lead. As we check in, that is a mess of things back there. Let's pop in with our race one winner here, Valkyrie. And the inside here of Neblol and Unku coming through turn one. We see just all of those multicolored Rise cars coming through. They do look so good and colorful in that field. Lots of two, three wide action throughout the field. Unku is still fighting back on the outside of Valkyrie coming down here into turn three. Unku will try to hold on the outside here through turn 4 as well. That will put him on the inside of turn 5 if he can't hold it. Looks like he gets just a little loose in the wet. Just can't quite hold it on the outside, but does try to fight back. Backs out of it. Going up here through the field, oh, we see PJ with a massive snap there as he falls back through the field now. Pop up here with Russo as we check on how things are going with the Zephyrus guys. It looks like the Zephyrus guys probably being a little bit more aggressive, a little bit more on it here with the traffic going through than the Rise Motorsports guys. They did all start in front of them, and they still do lead them that way. But They have moved up through the field a bit faster, as we see Hey Cranky up to 4th, Villa up to 5th, and then Russo and Gallardo in 8th and 9th. So tons of fighting, nice little over-under there moved by Russo on Cyrus. Coming up here, we're going to check on Hey Cranky as he tries to make a move on Dodge here for 3rd. Dodge doing very well, holding on to 3rd for this long. Apex Miata there in 2nd, and Taffy trying to drive away from his teammates there in 1st. As we see Cyrus very wide out there in the back. Let's go ahead and pop on back here. Neblaw and Amarius appear to be going at it as they are, yep, a couple, three cars wide sometimes back here throughout this field. Coming on through, Neblaw fighting very hard on the outside of Legless Man there. As they go side by side, we have more side by side up there in front. It looks like Nice Man and Unku. Nice Man and Unku is side by side. Vectrix is 3 wide there with Legrect and Cyrus, it looked like at the time. They are 4-5 wide on the front stretch, maybe? There's all kinds of crazy moves being thrown here. As we see the 318 there, I believe that's Amarius trying to make a move there. Yep, Amarius threw it up the inside. Looks like he did get one or two spots there, but lots of craziness going on throughout here. Lots of scratches on these cars. Lots of really hard racing as we go through the field here. Dodge just had a moment, it looks like, as he just fell down to 6th. Looks like the Zephyrus guys are finally making their way around him. We have Red Maverick right there behind him. Valkyrie to his outside, inside. Nope, Valkyrie to the inside of Red Maverick, though. Lots of really strong fighting throughout this field. These cars do really encourage really close racing, and there's a lot you can do for stuff like that. The rain is light. It is just slippery enough, it looks like, where it can cause people to make some slight mistakes. We're going to pop back here with Cyrus on board with him again as he just gets passed by Nice Man. We have a fight up here with Valkyrie and Dodge, it looks like. Yep. Valkyrie, your race one winner here, trying to move up into 7th. Looks like he will complete the pass in turn 1. I don't think Dodge will be able to fight back on the outside. He cannot. All right. The ZR guys are in a pretty proper cluster right there, all 4 of them. Their teammate Taffy actually out there leading the field. So Apex Miata is the only driver in the top 5 or 6 that isn't a Zephyrus Racing driver. Lots of stuff going on here as you see Apex Miata trying to hold on as he just gets absolutely swarmed by the sea of blue and white cars there from Zephyrus. Popping back further into the field, we have Unku side by side with somebody else. It looks like Unku, Nice Man, and Amarius are all going at it there. They're 3 wide for a second there with Cyrus as they go through this penultimate corner. Lots of tightness there. Vectrix comes in, has to shut the door on him. We see Dodge racing side by side up there with Nice Man now, and now Amarius as they are all once again trying to get back up to the front of the field from that reverse grid. Keep in mind that for race 3, we use the results of this race just as they are for the starting grid of race 3. So any positions you could earn here is a better starting position next race. Yeah, Valkyrie's really, really trying hard here. Looks like he has caught up to the back of the Zephyrus guys, who do run 1st through 5th now as they all got past Apex Miata. So Taffy has been caught by his teammates. We'll see what goes on there as, oh wow, that was an aggressive move by Valkyrie on Russo into turn 6 there. Looks like probably will be able to hold it on the inside of this corner and probably will be able to slide up in front of Russo here. Russo fighting back very hard on the outside but just can't hold it there. Yeah, lots of close racing. You see Valkyrie is starting to try to make his charge through these Zephyrus guys as Taffy and Cranky go side by side up here for the lead. Looks like Hey Cranky is able to clear Taffy, as is Via. Let's see, Via was the highest finishing car for Zephyrus last race, and looks like he is once again trying to be that man as he goes to the inside of his teammate here into turn 3 and clears him nicely. So that is probably that fight. Valkyrie does get up to 3rd there in turn 3. Valkyrie will be the man in the middle of all these Zephyrus racing guys here, being the only car not blue and white. He is definitely moving. We're going to pop back here and check on how things are going further back in the field. We're going to pop on board here with Cynerius. looks like there is some good fighting up here. We'll pop up here to Legolas, who appears to have been side by side with somebody there. Vectrix and Joost and Dodge all look like they're fighting here. As you see Dodge on the outside of Joost here into the final corner. Close racing, trying to go through it all. Still side by side here into turn one. The squab right in front of them, so Joost does have to keep that in mind when he backs out of that move, not to just send it into the back of him, as Dodge is able to hold on. Vectrix very wide onto the grass, going for a ride there on the exit. Looks like he's lost a couple other spots because of that. I'm going to pop up here, check in on Valkyrie, how he's doing against the Zephyrus guys. Valkyrie is still third, still fighting there in the middle. It looks like Nice Man has made it past one of them as well, made it past Amarius. Taffy is next on the list there as the Rise Motorsports guys try to get back up to the front. Legrecht, yeah, probably missed that. Don't know exactly what happened there, but Legrecht is running around at the back of the field right now. Probably somewhere in that shuffle got knocked off track or something like that. Just unfortunate, but one of the risks you have to take when you, with grids this large and stuff like that. Popping in, Juice here is in 14th. And we do have Nice Man up here in 7th. Via and Hey Cranky are starting to trade for the lead again. Via still has it for now, but that does mean Valkyrie is there now. Yeah, so as these two fight, that allows Valkyrie to make up a lot of time and get closer to these guys. Valkyrie trying to go 2-for-2 tonight on wins, but we'll see if he's able to do it. Looks like might have a move here on Hey Cranky. Not quite coming into this corner. We'll go on board with him. You basically do lose like 10 positions. Yeah, this track is, especially in the wet, is very unforgiving. It's very wide and forgiving, but if you do manage to go off on it, there's just a sand trap waiting for you. Valkyrie here looks like he's going to be trying to make a run on Hey Cranky into turn one. Going to try to be very smooth here through the final corner. Keep the speed up. Use the draft coming down the front stretch to try to launch yourself into turn one or two and try to make the move there. We're going to pop back here a little bit. Looks like there is some fighting further back in the field. I want to pop back here. Apex Miata maybe just had a moment. Apex Miata is fighting currently with Red Maverick and Unku, as we see Squab, Joost, and Cyrus also all trading right there, but we'll take a look at this battle first as Unku makes his move on Apex Miata. Very nice. Miata coming back on the outside, fighting back, coming down into turn three on the inside. Very late on the brakes, bit argy-bargy, but holding it together. Now has to fight back on the outside of turn four. This track is very, actually, surprisingly good for being able to carry side-by-side fighting through tons of corners because of how often it swaps back to which side has the better line. Unku looks like probably finally gets around Miata there. We're going to pop back here to Joost to see how he's doing as he takes on Squab here for 12th. AX4X Cyrus holding on there in 15th. It looks like FV Pixels and PJ are fighting back there. Legrecht is up to 20th, is slowly starting to make up those positions there. Let's pop on board with Neb, who is just in front of that group. Neb is trying to fight Foxmate here for 16th, as we see Legrecht in the background, the background there against Legolas, who's being sideways out of that final corner. These couple of three-car battles here, very close. As you see, all the cars have a bit of damage on the front, side, rear. Just kind of the nature of how these Ginettas race is, because they race so... they're so easy to race, and there's a lot less room for mistakes. You kind of have to make mistakes if you're going to pass people, pretty much. Either race close enough to somebody that you make them into one, or just let them know you're there every now and then. We're gonna pop up here. We're gonna check in on Valkyrie in the top three, and so he's doing. I believe the ZR guys are sorted themselves out for now. It looks like a little bit with Via and Hey Cranky in first and second. Gallardo and Russo running on 4th and 5th, right behind Valkyrie, and then Nice Man here in 6th, the second RZM. Nice Man was kind of relegated to Tail Gunner last race, running 4th in line for Rise Motorsports. This race, he is co-pilot here in 6th. Two more Zephyrus Racing guys with Amarius and Taffy holding on to 7th and 8th, and then a bit of a gap back to Red Maverick and Unku fighting for 9th. As we see, Unku has a run here on Maverick, trying to go in. We have Juiced right here as well in 12th, or in 11th, I should say. Go ahead and try to change the ticker back to intervals so it's easier to track these battles. Coming on through the field, Foxmate and Neblol are very close together here. Very close together as they are side by side there through turn 5 and 6. Cynerius thought about making it 3 wide there into that corner, decided against it. Might try to make it 3 wide on the exit. Nope, just a little tap on the back of Foxmate as everybody gets very loose. And here comes Legrecht on a move. Really aggressive move on the inside there. Has to lift on the apex and kind of just loses that run he had. And yep, and here comes Legless back on the inside of him now. Lots of really close, lots of switchbacks, close racing with these cars. You see these guys are running side by side into the majority of corners back here. Popping up here, it looks like Russo has got a run on Gallardo, or at least is running very close to him. We have Juiced, Maverick, and Unku, and Apex Miata all right there on top of each other as these guys are side by side. So we'll pop up and check on them here in just a moment once this looks like it might sort itself out a little more. Looks like Legrecht is starting to make moves, slowly working his way back up through the field, but we only have one lap left now. Wow, this race flew by. Unku here in ninth, trying to hold off Juiced. Come back here. We have Russo and Nice Man basically on top of each other. This is maybe just a timing glitch there for a second, but very, very close fight for fourth here between Russo, Gallardo, and Nice Man. Valkyrie also just on the tail of the two leaders in Via and Hey Cranky. Coming back down through the field, Unku looks like is side by side with Juiced. Juiced is by for now. Juiced is up into ninth. Coming back up here, we're going to check in on Via. Via looks like just got two more corners to go, two very easy corners to go. Just got to keep it neat and tidy to hold it on for the win there. Hey Cranky will make him work for it. Looks like he might be trying to get a run here into this final corner. I don't think Valkyrie has anything for them this late in the race. I believe that will be it for these guys. Looks like Hey Cranky might pull out, trying to make a move here. Cannot do it at the line. 0.067 at the line. As these guys are 3 wide across the line, and Nice Man does get Gallardo for 5th. Very, very close finish there. I have lost my screen. There we go. Can I have my screen back? Oh, Squab probably DNF'd there at the very end of the race. That is really unfortunate. Probably game crashed as soon as he crossed the line. Pop back, FV Pixels 22nd, and rounding out the race was Dodge. Yeah, Squab looks like he got 13th, and the game crashed as he crossed the line there. That is really unfortunate. Yeah, that was some crazy racing, that race. It was 4 or 5 wide several times. It's wild to watch stuff like that. I mostly just take these breaks as a chance to catch my voice. I'm not used to talking this much throughout the day. I work in tech. Come on, people. Ugh. Alright, we'll check out the race results here and go through those while they get things sorted for the next race. We have Via taking the win there. After finishing 3rd in race 1, comes 1st in race 2. Hey Cranky recovering quite nicely from his 9th place finish there in race 2. It was 8th to finish 2nd. Valkyrie coming home 3rd. Very strong run there for Valkyrie. I believe he did take the fastest lap as well, but just couldn't quite get up there for the by the end of the race in time. We have Russo in 4th, Nice Man in 5th, Gallardo in 6th, Amaryllis in 7th and Taffy in 8th. Unku in 9th and Arzium Juiced in 10th. That's a very close finish there between several of those guys as we come and we look. Russo and Niceman had 0.009 between them at the line. Very close racing there to the end. And there was just another 0.06 back to Gallardo as they were three wide across the line. Coming down here, we have Maverick in 11th, Miata in 12th, Squab in 13th, Cyrus in 14th, Neblol in 15th, Vectrix in 16th, Legrecht in 17th, Foxmate in 18th, Leglessman in 19th, Cynerius in 20th, and then PJ, FV, Pixels, and Dodge rounding out your field there. I do believe I will try to get Dark back in here for the final race, but I am going to try to add Discord sound capture first. Which one was it? All right, he should be able to join back and hear me now. Yeah, Brands Hatch was a bit of a it's a classic. We couldn't not race it in these cars. But man, the Indy track just kind of encourages oversteer and things like that in these cars with all the apexes on hills and the way you have to race into some of the corners. Grand Oaks, nice and wide. It's very fast, but it's very forgiving, as you can see. If you go side by side with somebody into a corner, you do get the next line, basically. We have a couple people here trying to go through the group. We will come back to the main menu here. All right, yeah, 28 for NA at the moment. I think there were 27 signed in for EU. A couple people said no because they weren't feeling too great. Scroll up here. Anything I missed that was talking in the chat? Yeah, RZM Phoenix does the RZM paints. He did very, very good job on these. Very good team design language there across that. Same thing for the Zephyrus guys, all running the same car like that. Yeah, this is upper C class. I wanted to keep it below C as close as I could. If you win race one, you're screwed for race two and three. Not necessarily, but it's always the risk you got to take. Do you strategically try to finish worse in race one, lose points there to try to win it back later, or do you just race as hard as you can? I mean, the cars are just so close here too. All right, pop into spectate here. This is a night race this time, and I believe if I check the calendar, this was medium rain. Oh, this is light rain. It was drizzle last race. This is light rain this race. So stepping up the rain level one more time for this final race here. Also, with the way the track rubber starts, the track will actually get slipperier throughout the race. So fastest laps will actually be on the first couple laps here as the track rubbers in. All right. With that two last turns. Yeah, you have to really pick. Oh, I think you get to talk about Team Wars. I will be back momentarily.
I'm back. Hello, hello. Can you hear me, Brad? All right, so I'm. Looks like you guys get me for a minute or two here. So I did try to join for race number two there, but it looks like you guys weren't able to hear me. That's okay. We will adjust as such. Been quite a while since I've been in the comms booth. My goodness. Usually I do the Indy 500 and maybe one or two stints in an Enduro a couple times a year, but I was moving when we did Indy, so I wasn't able to do it. Yeah, we didn't spectate. But let's take a look at our standings so far while we wait for Brad to return for Geneta Challenge EU. Keeping in mind that round number two is incomplete with one race still on the cards, RZM Valkyrie is sitting on top with 982 points out of a possible, as of this point in time, 1,000. Remember, there's another 200 points on offer from race three available. Via Rondo, aka ZR Via, in second with 960, followed by RZM Nice Man with 954. Rest of your top 10, ZR Russo, Gallardo, RZM Juiced, Just Unku, ZR Hi-Hi Cranky and Taffy, and Neblol. Been also informed that Neblol will not be returning for race number three of this round, meaning that somebody else will easily steal that top 10 position. My personal bet is it'll be either Amarias or Sanirias, as they are 11th and 12th currently in standings.
I have returned.
Hello.
I have water.
Are you discovering the parched throat syndrome of talking for a half hour continuously?
I'm used to that.
Yeah.
No, I ran out of drink in that race. So I...
Oh.
Yeah, I have returned with water, and my roommate is going to Chick-fil-A and is getting me a sandwich. So today, everything's looking up.
Well, this is good.
Yep. See, bring myself down a little bit. There we go.
So we got one more race, Brad. This one is going to be gridded by the direct results of race number two. No more reverse grid. Which means that Via, who made up 13 spots in a lap and a half in that second race, now has clear air to start. Oh, boy.
Yeah, and Valkyrie is right behind him, though. It took Valkyrie most of the race to catch them last time, but was there at the end, and now is just there at the start.
Yeah, I haven't raced against Valkyrie for quite some time, but I do remember him being one of the less aggressive alien drivers in the Enduros. Usually to good effect, because it meant he didn't take any risks, car wasn't broken, and he was able to put up solid miles pretty much every time. But on the other hand, one of our newer Toro competitors, he is a very assertive driver. Not to the point of being unfair, but if there is a gap, he will at least look at it. And I think that really does behoove somebody starting at the back in a reverse grid race like what we just saw. Now this race, this is going to be light rain, so the track will be at its slowest condition of the night, I believe, correct?
Correct, yeah, and with... Okay, Dodge is backwards there.
Dodge, what are you doing, buddy?
No, that's fine. It'll be the slipperiest condition of the night, and also with the dynamic rubbering we're using in this series compared to other ones, since we're not starting the rubber at 100%, the track will actually be grippiest for the first couple laps.
That is something that really screwed me up last time we used the rain with the dynamic rubber. I was like, why am I going slow? Forgetting that rain and rubber don't mix well.
Yeah, this is one of the cool things that they did that actually somehow works in this game.
I don't know if a rubbered line and a not rubbered line exist. I think it's more just a universal grip change. But
I believe so as well, yeah.
It's a nice change compared to FM7.
Also, it's quite weird how the Ginettas have one bright on and one dim on, but I'm just going to blame British Electrics for that one. We're going to go ahead and take a look.
Weird,
oh,
yeah.
God. I did the thing with my cat with that first.
All right. So I do have a question for you, because I admittedly did not watch the full second race there. What happened to Legrecht? Did he have an issue?
We missed it, but at some point he was just last on track.
Okay. So that tells me he might have gotten sent to the gravel trap at one point.
Yeah. So once again, going down your list, we have ZR Via starting on pole, followed by Hey Cranky here in second. We have Valkyrie in third with the Rise Motorsports guys. Russo in fourth. Nice Man earning himself fifth with that pass there at the line.
Nice.
Gallardo here in sixth. Amaryllis here in seventh. Taffy here in eighth. Rounding out the batch of Zephyrus guys there. Then we have Rise Motorsports Juiced. And Red Maverick rounding out your top 10.
All right. In the 12th position, we're going to have Apex Miata on the outside of row number 6, followed by SGR Squab
and
AX4X Cyrus. Nebelol, of course, would be 15th, but is not in this race, meaning Vectrix will start in 15th position alongside RZM Legrecht. Then we're going to have Foxmate 21 and a Legless Man 12, Cinerius, PJ Back, and then your last two drivers will be Pixels and Dodge. Brad, I'm nervous for these guys.
We're going to go on board here with the Valkyrie at the start, I believe. And we're going to try to go with the rail camera here for the start. We're going to try that out this time. So as you can
see, once we figure out a way to like really smoothly get that used, I think it's going to be absolutely fantastic, especially ovals or really things like this, just close quarters combat. Any second now, we could be going green.
Just waiting on a couple people back there on the grid to line up. Seems like some people might have skipped a grid slot a little bit. And the cars do look like they're moving a lot right there. That is mostly just Forza D-Sync moving the cars back and forth a little bit. These guys are actually just holding their spot pretty solidly here. Don't worry about that. It's just the way Forza sees cars rev up and thinks they're driving when they're not.
Definitely a long hold here.
There were some people at the back who were still shuffling to get into position. All right. This is kind of fun. I could just sit here and spin. And they're off. Bit of a bad start there for Valkyrie as Nice Man comes up here with Russo as they're going to go three wide into the first corner here. No, it looks like
Valkyrie started in the wrong gear.
It's possible. We got Amarius and Gallardo there right behind. We get a nice wide angle camera here coming out into turn two. Looks like Via has just driven off in the front here for this start. Valkyrie looks to be looking on the outside of Russo here coming into turn three. Nice Man is on the inside there of it. Looks like Amarius trying to go through here.
Contact.
The Rise Motorsport guys very, very early trying to get up and into it early in this race. That's for sure.
You know, and I really do think something needs to be said just about the meteoric rise of the ZR, the Zephyrus Racing team. They didn't exist in Tora in FM7, and now they are routinely at the front winning races and team championships and just generally putting up good results. So a team to keep an eye on as we go through the game's life.
A team that, yeah, really first showed up at Tora when we were doing the Trans Am series. Yeah. We're going to pop back here, check in on how things are going further back in the field as we have Squab, Miata, and it looks like Legrecht here, all three wide down the front stretch there for a moment.
Legrecht up, I believe, five positions already.
More people on the grass back there that look like it was Vectrix getting wide outside of turn one here. That is Cinerius and Pixels. Popping back up here, we're going to check in on how Unku is doing here, holding on 2/10 for now. And a bit of a...
For those unaware, the head marshal EU for Toro, one of our fellow staff members. Great to see him having a good day.
It's right there in a Rise Motorsport sandwich between Juiced and Legrecht, as Legrecht is up to 11th now. Bit of a Zephyrus Racing trio there just in front of them as they're all going side by side. Valkyrie is... on the back of Villa here, as Villa lost the lead to Hey Cranky there. So probably had a bit of a mistake there on that first lap. We got more Zephyrus Racing guys side by side down the front stretch here, as it looks like that is Juiced trying to make a move back there. Yep, Juiced to the inside, three wide into turn one. Makes it work.
He really thought about it as well on Villa. It looks like he did actually make that move stick. I thought he was backing out of it on the entry there. But three wide again. And that is a huge wiggle and kind of side of contact, opposite sides there between the ZR guys and RZM. And now it is three wide. Unko on the outside.
Three wide,
that
three,
is the
four
prime
wide
position here. Because when it turns back, he'll be able to pass three or four of those guys if he's able to stick it there. And it looks like instead of that happening, the opposite has occurred and they've all stayed in front.
God, that is... There is still 3-4 wide right there. I see Squab right there in the mix of that too. Just... What a giant fight for 10th, yeah.
Yeah, that's like Rex kind of acting as the cork in the bottle there. Just nobody can clear him fully without also losing a spot to somebody else. Something to keep an eye on.
Pop up here, we're going to check on Valkyrie, see if he has a run on Hey Cranky. He does have a run on Hey Cranky here into turn one.
Starting to see a breakaway forming as well, about 2 seconds between our top six and RZM Juiced, leading the Forza Peloton, for a little cycling terminology. Valkyrie all over the back of Cranky. He is going to want to try to stick to that right side here. So instead, he does the exact opposite of what I said, and now he's going to try to go for the switchback.
Yep, you could fight back on the outside there, but it really puts you at disadvantage later in the racetrack here, because while you can hold it on the inside of this corner, you're at such a disadvantage on the outside coming into this corner that you'd really rather be on the outside, because you could really swing it off there.
Villa really thought about that there and then did back out of it, but
backed out of it after a bit of contact there, Valkyrie catching the car there. Looks like man with a nice move on Amarius there, coming through that next to last corner.
How long have you been wanting to say that?
No comment. Coming back here, we got Legrecht on Taffy here for 10th place. Red Maverick has actually cleared both of them there up into 9th. So Red Maverick being the man that isn't Rise Motorsports or Zephyrus up there in the top 10. Having a really good race.
It's kind of a strange feeling when you're surrounded by people on teams and you're just kind of there. It almost feels like you're intruding on something private. But sometimes not having to worry about your teammates gives you a little bit more freedom. Okay, maybe I am going to try to pass this guy. Because you're not playing the team game of trying to maximize points across yourselves. You're just going for your own goal.
There has been zero team orders tonight, I can tell you that much, based on how I've seen both Rise Motorsports and Zephyrus Racing race each other, let alone racing in like racing each other between the like in between the team, let alone racing each other team.
No, and I wouldn't expect it so early as well. Maybe as we get into the last round or two, you might see a little bit of tactician thinking coming to the fore. Looks like Squab and Unku going at it once more here for 12th. 12th being the first of the second half, because again, we don't have Nebwall for this race. Right in the slipstream of Taffy. Shout out to Forza for giving us a full leaderboard with intervals. That is so nice.
Legrecht was able to clear Maverick there into turn one, by the way. Was able to get the move done there, as you see now Squab making a move back on Unku.
That would be, I believe, Legrecht's 8th position gained during this race. Much harder to pass not during the reverse grid, because in theory, the higher up you go, the faster you get. So, very impressive drive from him.
Lots of movement happening back here at the back, too. I just saw these guys were, 2-3 wide again. These, ever since race one, Vectrix, Legless, Foxmate, and Cinerius have been basically an inseparable quad of cars. There's been great racing between these guys, too. Tons of room given and everything.
And this is really a great car to try to get your racing chops in, because it is hard to drive. It doesn't necessarily handle the best, and you really have to think to make a fast stick. So if you're a new driver just working on racecraft, you're going to have good racecraft just to even stay in touch. So I'm really happy with what we're seeing here, with so many drivers being able to battle this closely for so long.
One thing we did miss, getting distracted by all the fighting going on throughout the field, was that Valkyrie was able to pass Villa for the lead, and now Villa is being... harassed by Nice Man here, trying to...
Actually, I think it was Cranky in the lead. He's now down to fourth, so we've had a top four inversion here. That is a big change. So, Nice Man was riding that inside bumper from Villa, and then it looks like he did back out of it to allow him to take the corner. Very heads-up driving.
Yep, so Nice Man trying to get up there and make this a Rise Motorsports 1-2. Looks like PJ did just disconnect there for some reason. Was running further back in the field, so probably had a bit of an issue there, or maybe just disconnected. Every time I see these cars come down the front stretch, I just think of the song, the road's lit up by one headlight.
I'm going to be completely honest, I do not know the song.
It's fine. It's my own little... Oh, man, Nice Man with another really good move there onto Villa there into turn two. That was very clean and tidy there on the inside, yeah. We're glad we were able to catch that. Kind of pop back here and check how the other Rise Motorsports guys are doing on the back of this.
Oh, we got a spin. Via some twitch. Oh,
Via
caught it. Okay.
Via caught it, but God, that car was. I read the side of it there in the middle of that corner. So Via now from
Frankie and Amarillo's through.
Via now fighting his teammates here, basically two or three wide here for fifth. This is the Rise Motorsports guys are actually able to get a bit of a gap finally and run away there. Juice.
Now, this is where you'd back it off the aggression if you were on a team, and you just make sure that you get 1-2, and then with a couple laps to go, then start fighting again. That's what I would do anyway. I don't know if they're going to do the same thing.
Juiced with a nice move there on Russo on the front stretch, trying to see if he can make it work. Looks like Legrecht is going to make it three wide into turn one.
That was a NASCAR style run. He just shot up the inside, and he's going to get both of them.
He is, and it looks like Russo is now fighting back. Russo was able to do the crossover on both of them coming into turn two. Wow, that was such a slingshot of a move from Russo there to get both of them on that short shoot. I thought he would get Juice, but I didn't think he'd be able to get Legrecht as well. Legrecht now fighting back on the inside of this corner here, but is forced to back off a bit here. So
I think in that moment, Russo was playing chess and those guys were playing checkers.
Yeah, so at the end of all of that, what happens is Legrecht passes his teammate after the end of that crazy move there.
But crucially, I think they did actually gain a little bit of time on Gallardo, about a half second. So if they can keep up that pace, they'll get him on the last lap. That's not going to be easy, though. Gallardo is genuinely quick.
Villa is back to the lead of that ZR group, by the way, up there leading Hey Cranky, who leads side-by-side now. I was popping back here to check in on how that battle with Vectrix was doing, but we'll hop up here now. And Hey Cranky was not able to pull it side by side there into turn one. We'll try to see if he can do it into turn three. Tons of lines available to you here on this track based on how you run. And yeah,
he just drove around him.
Via just backed out of it. Goodness. Let him have that. Yeah.
Yeah, I think this was touched on in the chat earlier by Freelancer, but Via's car does not appear to be liking the more damp conditions that the drivers are dealing with at this point.
Yeah, it's probably set up pretty loose for qualifying conditions, and as the track gets slippery and slipperier, he's probably having to fight it quite heavily. Legrecht is up to 7th. He was able to get around Russo, finally. Juiced is next, but Juiced has Squab on his tail.
Yeah, Legrecht just took out another 4/10 there out of Gallardo that last lap, so he is moving, but not quite at the rate needed to get the position done.
Yeah, I mean, if those four Zephyrus Racing guys keep going like that, like Design said here in the Twitch chat, yeah, Legrecht will get up there and catch up to them.
Yeah, but you might have to bring a couple friends with them. Juiced and Squab are kind of lying astern at the moment.
Got Red Squab. Maverick and Taffy going at it here, it looks like. Just really close, part trying to make a move. Oh, Taffy, very defensive there in turn two.
Yeah,
able to block that.
A little too much curve.
Taffy was able to really park the bus on the apex, so he couldn't cross over. So coming back through the field, anything else going on back here? We got Vectrix, Foxmate, and Cinerius all really close to each other behind Apex here. He's just in the background. We'll check on them really fast. All pretty calm, all things considered, based on how those guys have been racing each other all night. Legrecht seems to have taken another 10th out of them, but with only 4 laps left, that is not enough if he wants to be able to get up there and catch those.
At this race, he'll catch them on lap 35, which will be a little too late.
Probably not running full aero.
However,
that is probably correct, yeah.
Yeah, full arrow is the play here, which is counterintuitive for a lower class car, but you need it in the Jannetta. Cranky taking some time out of Nice Man, but again, I don't think the rate of closure is going to be quite enough to allow him to make a move before the race is over.
I think they're mostly just the Rise Motorsports guys and the leader just kind of running around right now. They've got a bit of, you know, we've got a second and a half between Valkyrie and Nice Man, another second and a half between him and Cranky, pretty much. And they're just kind of holding gap, holding steady. So we see Squab here fighting Juice now for ninth. Really loose.
Oh, I thought he was going to go around.
Really loose out of that corner there.
You know, as loose as he just got, I think he is actually got a slight advantage here on raw pace compared to Juice, at least at this point. That could be something that's just a tire pressure change working its way in, different starting fuel loads. There's so many variables that actually do make a difference now in this incarnation of motorsport.
The draft is so strong, too, coming out into this corner.
Juiced now only 6/10 of a second buffer. That gap was over a second a couple laps ago.
Taffy and Maverick going at it here, fighting side by side through turn one. Taffy is able to hold him off now, coming out into turn two. They were side by side down that entire front stretch. I was watching that.
Kashi is wondering if his teammate has engine damage. That would certainly allow for some explanation of the reduced pace. Well, there it is. Russo is through.
Oh, that's not it. That's,
I think you want one more to the right there. Not the driver data.
Nope. No damage.
Oh, yeah.
Just low fuel. He's down to 5% fuel.
I don't think he needs to be saving at this point. It's just strange. Two laps to go here. Still RZM Valkyrie now with a 2.2 second lead over RZM Nice Man with Via further 2 seconds drift and Cranky on his six as they're going three wide or thinking about it. Squab backing out at the last possible moment there. Three wide again and Squab again doesn't force the issue, but Juice somehow retains the spot. Russo and Squab hot on his heels. And LeGreg is 1 second now off Gallardo. That could happen on the last lap if something were to happen. But
tons of fighting throughout the field, and there's just too many fights to look at. It's really spoiled for choice here, because I've seen at least three separate times that lap gaps go down to sub 1/10 of a second. I was trying to look through and see what was going on. So we'll pop back up here. Hey, Cranky, looks like he's a side-by-side. Hey, Cranky and Via are nuts to butts as they come down here through this corner.
Gap now coming up to about a half a second.
Yeah, as they come to the
Cranky
corner.
Cranky might be doing that whole tactical thinking and just not wanting to throw away a podium there.
LeGrecht down to under half a second, but probably going to run out of time unless he gets mega run in these last couple corners.
Well, he's going to get at least two opportunities to get a decent toe there, and that gap is now 3/10. So that is within lunging range if he's feeling brave. He's got a pretty 5 second gap back as well. So
have to lunge into
no
this corner though. We are
here
on the final lap. Yeah.
He's taking a wider entry, gonna try to narrow it up on the exit and then just gas it home.
Yeah, gonna try really hard to over under it here. Oh, very loose on exit, yeah. It'll pop up here.
Race winner.
RZM Valkyrie. Followed by Nice Man. But like here. Gallardo and Amarius are able to hold off LeGrecht. Pop back here to Squab. Oh, side by side for Juiced and Russo, but Russo gets him.
Margin there less than 1/10 of a second. That is pretty solid.
Coming back. Oh, yeah, everybody ripping the e-brake across the line, but holding their position strong.
Two drivers remaining. Cyrus in our position number 20, and our Caboose for race number 3. Dodge, who I think is having a little bit of fun there. Shout out again to Dodge for hanging on to the top 3 position for a pretty considerable amount of time in race number 2. I was impressed with that.
Yeah, he drove really well in race 2. Yeah.
Dodge, a member of the Toro dev team, focusing on ensuring cars are Nice to drive.
Yep, so going through the field, we have Valkyrie, Niceman, and Via, your podium that we will see here in just a moment. So there they are. Race 3 podium. We got Via there in third, Niceman there in second, and Valkyrie with the second win of the night for him. So he goes first, third, first for these three races.
And of course, we will have the results updated in just a few moments' time as the marshals get that entered on ORM. Brad, have you explained to these fine folk how to get involved with this year's series at this point?
I have had the ticker going at the bottom, but if you go to racetora.com, that will take you to our link tree that will show you everything Tora related. There's a link on there for ORM, there's a link on there for our socials, and there's a link on there for our Discord, where if you join the Discord, we'll have all the information on there you can need about the series. You could talk with other competitors and see all the builds and everything there.
You can also check out past Tora broadcasts on the Tora YouTube channel and saved Twitch highlights on our Twitch, both of which are publicly accessible. We also have an Instagram and a Twitter for social media. So lots of ways to keep track of all the Tora action. And if you want to see a trip down memory lane, the Tora forum is on there as well. All the way back to 2008, I believe. Lots of history on Tora.
All right, going to go through one final time the finishing position for race 3. So once again, we had Valkyrie, Niceman, and Via there on the podium, with Via actually having the fastest lap of the race, it looks like. Hey, Cranky, Gallardo, and Amarias could round out the rest of that Zephyrus squad there from 4th to 6th. Legrecht, Russo, and Joost from 7th, 8th, and 9th. And then SGR Squab rounds out your top 10.
Did run through the preliminary standings as we were waiting for race 3 to get underway, but now the results have been entered, we have the actual standings. So your current points leader, to the surprise of no one, is RZM Valkyrie with 1,182 out of a possible 1,200 points. Via Rondo, ZR Via, 30 points adrift, with Niceman a further 3 back. Rest of your top 10, Russo, Gallardo, Joost, Cranky, Unku, Amarias, and Taffy. Over to the team standings, Rise Motorsport with an excellent showing, holding on to the first position with 2,315 points, ahead of Zephyrus Blue at 2,254 and Zephyrus White at 2,216. On the privateer's side, currently P1 is Unku under the name Swordfish Motorsport with 1,080 points. Zephyrus Red has 1,065. Let's see who that is. That's going to be ZR Amarias. And third position privateers is Wii Racing with 1,044 points. That driver is Sinarius. And we can do this all again in about 4 hours for Geneta Challenge NA.
Yeah, so if you guys are interested, this is only the second round of Geneta Challenge. This was the EU race. We do have another one better time slotted for the North American or really anybody else who maybe likes a later race for them. That will happen in, just over 4 hours from now. If you guys want to sign up for that, we'll be back at the same track and the same races. There are still 4 more races in this season for either one. If you want to race after this week here at Grand Oak, we do have open registration for the entire length of the series. If you only want to come in and do one round, that's fine. If you want to come in and do the last 4, that's fine. Whatever you guys want to do. So the calendar after this is next week we will be at Silverstone National. Then after that we will be at the new track most recently added to Forza Motorsport, Road Atlanta, for the short course race. After that we will be heading to Hockenheim National for a night race there, and then we will finish off the season at Mid-Ohio on the short circuit for another wet race.
No breaks in this season, so they are all back-to-back-to-back. And if you did miss the first round, you can still win the championship because we have a drop. So if you want to get involved and you're able to make all the remaining rounds, you have a chance.
Alrighty. You guys have yourselves a good rest of the night.
See yous later. Thank you.